R2, is that you?
Hello everyone, and welcome to a bit of Star Wars Battlefront. This is an early copy on EA Access at the minute. I did play the base of this game, not sure whether that's on my channel, but this is not a review for now. This is just a bit of a live gameplay with some first impressions. After playing... Hang on a minute. We got one. After playing the beta, I actually become interested in this game. I mean, I seen it at first when it was first announced. I thought, you know what? Doesn't look too bad that, because at the time I was playing a lot of Battlefield, and so I thought, you know what, I'll probably have a look into this game. Play the beta, great. Just playing the first few matches on me actual full game of it now, a little bit early on Xbox One, and yeah, it hasn't differed too much from the beta, which is a good thing, I suppose. So this is just sort of a live gameplay where we're just gonna basically show you the game, just uncut footage, and so that maybe you can decide if you want to get it or not. But I think I'll definitely be, well, in fact, you know what, I am getting this game, I've already got it pre-ordered. So yeah, already got it pre-ordered. As to whether I'll be getting the season pass for this game, I don't know yet. I mean, I'd like to see what's included in that season pass. But I imagine it's just more maps and things. So, if I do invest a lot of time to this game, then yeah, I'll probably get the season pass. But I'm gonna wait to see what that has inside it first. What else has been going on actually at the minute? Been playing a lot of Fallout 4, but I haven't made any videos on that. Just trying to enjoy my first playthrough first, and then maybe we'll see something to do with Fallout 4 a bit later. Maybe a few guides on things, I don't know. We'll see. But I... Oh, hang on. The haze there. I suppose you'd want a small review of this game. Obviously, it's just a shooter, a bit like Battlefield. Obviously, more like Battlefield with it being made by Dice and EA. But in terms of being like a good shooter, I'd say it was an easy shooter. Like, whereas Battlefield kind of has these, you know, these complications to it, if you will. This is just easy, you know, pick up and play. And of course, the other half of it is that it's Star Wars. So, if you're a Star Wars fan, I'm sure you're gonna really, really, really like this game. I mean, I don't follow Star Wars myself, but as a shooter, it's good. So it's great for both audiences, really. You've got a really nice combination of, well, genres and licenses here, which is fantastic. Hopefully that infantry should take him out. Let's get a grenade in there. We got him. What the hell's that? Some serious firepower coming from there. It's actually kind of hard to play this game when you're trying to commentate on. It's one mechanic in it. You get these little power-ups that you pick up in the map. And, oh. Well, that's pointless. Oh, my God, we got someone here. Killed him. Bit of a fight going on here. Don't think that was going anywhere. Got one. So as you can see, man, like, the gunfights, they're not like Call of Duty where you rush into someone and you're like, oh, yeah, it's all just, it's a big cluster thing, you know, it's just like a big kerfuffle, as I like to say. It's actually quite calm for a shooter. Of course, this is just a team deathmatch world where the only objective, well, it's called Blast, where the only objective is just, you know, team deathmatch. But there's some really, like, how do I put it? What EA likes to do, like, campaign-ish kind of modes. Like this Walker Assault where you have to work on defending or attacking AT-ATs. Those big, massive robot camels. I think you should know what that is. See, I mean, even if, like, say you're not a Star Wars fan, like I'm not, and but you like shooters, then it's great. It's a great theme, it's a great universe to set a game like this in, I think. Come on. Move, kid. And go. I'm not sure whether my rocket went off there. We'll find out now. No, it didn't. The rocket didn't fire. So that was my my power pickup that I got, the smart rocket. Which is what? The other guy just killed me then. But then, ironically. Oh, here we go, here we go. Come on. Oh. He's gone into this cave. Hunt him down. Right, back it up here. Hopefully he'll come a bit further out and get hit by that. Nope. Let's take a different view, take a different vantage point then. There. Oh, that's something that's quite unique about this game. There's no actual ammo counter on any guns, they're all blasters. And basically they just overheat, that's the only thing they have to do. But they can actually be quickly cooled down if it's like some like timed active reload thing that they have with that. Which works quite well actually. And I've put like a proximity bomb right there. Our team's actually quite losing quite badly here. Oh, we're actually hiding under this. That's quite neat. Oh, we sail right through that. What a camping spot. Wait. There's someone right there, but we can't actually get through that end. Ah, see, this map seems a little bit tight to me. I mean, most of the maps are like quite open spaces, and there's a lot of long-range engagements in this game, which is good to see. And it all works well as a shooter, and as a Star Wars fan service as well, from what I've heard from other people. Oh, it's over. Just infinitely getting shot by the infantry. Anyway, so we reached rank 4. Unfortunately, we lost, but I did come second. And I come second with a terrible score as well, so, you know, what does that say about the rest of the team? So, yeah, that was basically just Star Wars Battlefront in the flesh. There it is. That's how it is. In fact, that wasn't that accurate because, you know, there's a lot more different maps, but that's just sort of a first impression thing, what I think of it. I've already pre-ordered the game. I'll be getting the full digital copy. I mean, not the digital copy. Full physical copy when it comes out. Yeah, and maybe you'll see some Fallout 4 videos soon as well. There's another thing to look out for. So if you haven't already, guys, subscribe. And if you enjoyed this video and thought it was informative, then leave a like.